I don't know if you know this, but I did not go to college. It wasn't that I didn't want to go, it was just that I was going through a very, very difficult time in my life at that point. And I had also had a front row seat to watch my mother struggle to put my older sister through college. And I didn't want to be that kind of burden on her. I knew firsthand the hardship. And especially, you know, because the truth be told, I wasn't that good of a student. I was smart, but I didn't have the patience to learn a lot of the things that I thought wouldn't serve me in life. You know how hard-headed teenagers can be, they think they know it all. Well, I was one. Sitting there in school, I would get so frustrated because I never thought that I would use a lot of what I was being taught in my real life. And to give that little hard-headed kid some props, there's a few things he was right about to a degree. Because I can honestly say in the 27 years since I left high school, nobody has ever asked me about the square root of nothing. Nobody has ever asked me about the Nina, the Pinta, or the Santa Maria. Nobody, Jane and Susie had four apples, walked 5 miles, they divided no apple. Listen, I never met Jane and I never met Susie. I know some of you are thinking, why are you telling these young folks this? They have just studied, they've learned all this, but I just want you to know, you ain't gonna use all of it. But that's okay, that's okay. Some of your faces are saying right now, you mean to tell me I could have skipped college and been rich and successful like Tyler Perry? While that is possible, I want to tell you that the advantage that all of you graduates have over me, this education, this college degree that you have worked so hard for, I envy you. Because if I could get back half the time and the monies that I spent and wasted because of what I didn't know, I could have paid for everybody's education in this entire school. You see, somebody say, go ahead, listen. See, you see, come on now, I only got 20 minutes to get through this. Listen, maybe 30, listen. You see, it was what I didn't know and that I didn't get in college that made it difficult for me to run my business in the beginning. It was what I didn't know, the basics of business, that if I had gone to college, could have learned them, which would have helped me so much. Now, don't feel sorry for me, I'm doing all right. But my journey would have been so much easier had I taken advantage of the kind of education that you have been afforded here at Tuskegee. When I was growing up, my father was a carpenter. He would take me to work with him. And in the summertime, you know, it was really hot, and I'd be out there with him, and he'd be building these houses. And the part that I hated most about this was when we had to put in the foundation. The part that was very labor intensive. There were the footings that had to be dug to a certain depth. However tall the building was, that's how deep the footings had to be. It was painstaking, you know, digging these holes. And I grew up in New Orleans, so you had to put in these 30-foot pilings sometimes in the ground to be able to support the building. So just to know that, then it had to be what we called form, where you put these boards around, and then you had to tie the steel. And after all that work was done, you just poured concrete over it. And here's the thing, after it was all done, if nobody ever saw it. All that work was done and nobody ever saw it. No one ever cared about the foundation. The only time you hear someone talk about the foundation is when a house is falling apart. But when the foundation is done right, nobody mentions it. And when it's done right, it can carry the weight of anything that it was designed to hold. Well, that's what you've been doing here. You've been building a foundation, one that will hold you up for the rest of your life. And you know, when I was a kid, I would ask myself, you know, why is nobody paying attention to this foundation? Why did this work have to be so hard? Have you ever wondered, for some of you, why it had to be so hard to get through school or just make it from day to day? Well, that's because what you were building had to be strong enough to support the weight of whatever you could dream. And if you're like me, you are a huge dreamer. You had to have a foundation that is big enough and strong enough and bold enough to hold all of your dreams and handle them coming true. That's why in life, it's not always an even playing field. What I mean by that is this: while for some, studying, good grades may have come easy, but for others, every day here may have been a struggle. For some, mom and daddy had money to write the check with tuition with ease, but for others, they had to make a choice between paying a bill and getting your books.
Yeah.
For some, it was easy to focus and learn, while others were distracted by problems that they were going through at home or working two jobs to make ends meet. All that means is that you were being designed to handle different levels of success. I mean, truth be told, no one really knows what you went through to be able to sit in this very seat. They don't know the hell or the turmoil, but trust me when I tell you, all of it was to make you strong. Strong enough to go through whatever you have to go through to get to your dreams coming true. I want you to ask yourself this question today. How much can my foundation hold? As you think about that, I need to warn you, it takes a while to build a dream. Think about that when you get out there and you're faced with all kinds of challenges. When you get out there in the world, I want you to remember something. What's in the well will come up in the bucket. So thank God that mama and daddy and big mama and grandpa and Tuskegee, they put some good stuff down in your well. So listen to me. No matter what happens, you've got good stuff down inside of you. You can always count on it, so you remember that. But what happens if you get out there and you find yourself saying, I thought I'd have this job by now or that job by now. I thought I'd be working here or there by now. Why aren't they calling me back? Why haven't I been hired? You see, when you leave the protection of the walls of Tuskegee, when you step out from under mama and daddy's shadow, because I want to tell you something. Mom and daddy protecting you is one thing, but that world out there is a whole nother thing to deal with. So what do? When you have worked this hard, built this foundation, everything you are trying to build on it seems to not be coming together. What happens if you find yourself at an interview and realize that you are being judged because of your name, or because of the color of your skin, or because of your size, or because of who you love, or where you come from? What if in a few years you find yourself at a glass ceiling that the one in the career that you thought you so desperately wanted? What do? What happens when the job that you wanted or the career that you planned for doesn't come right away? What do? Well, it was 1991. I was just about your age then, and I had written my first play. It was called I Know I've Been Changed. It was about adult survivors of child abuse, and I wanted to do this show, and just my intention was just to make enough money to be able to take care of my mother. That's all I wanted to do. That was my goal. Make the money and retire her. Anyway, I had just moved to Atlanta to try and launch this place, so I went to work. I would always work. You have to always work. You gotta always go to work. I managed to save $12,000 and I put the show up, working, used car, bill collector, H&R block tax return that wasn't quite right, but I got my money out of it. I thought 1,200 people would show up that weekend, but only 30 showed up. My car payment, rent, everything was tied up in it, so I ended up homeless. I ended up out on the street with no money and nothing to my name. But I knew that that is what I was supposed to be doing. I knew that I was on a good foundation. I had put in the work. This was supposed to work. It was supposed to be successful, but it wasn't. Over and over again, it failed, or so I thought. From 1992 to 93 to 94, every year I was doing one show a year. I would go get a job in between and they would tell me I couldn't take time off. So I would quit. Now I'm not telling you to go quit your job, I'm telling you what I did. This is my story. I would go tell my boss that I need some time off, and they'd say, no, you just got started working, you just got this job, you can't have any time off. But I knew that that was my destiny, so I kept on doing the play. Every year I would do it, it would fall short, until 1998. In 1998, in the seventh year of me trying, I was about to give up and walk away. I had enough of it. I was going to do like my mother said. She said, baby, go down to the phone company, get you a good job, making about $350 a week and some benefits, and you'll be all right. But how many of you know mama's dream for you is not necessarily your dream for yourself? I knew I was in the right place when one day I started getting notes from people, this was before email, who had seen the show. They would say, this really touched me. This really helped me. They started telling me how it had changed their lives, how they were moved by it. Then I realized, wait a second, this story that I'm telling about these adult survivors getting over things, this isn't just about me or where I come from. It's a healing for many people. I saw it, I got it, and it hit me, and my intention changed. At that moment, it was no longer about making enough money to take care of anybody. It became about what it did for the people who saw it, who saw themselves. My entire intention changed in 1998, and everything in my life shifted after that. I was still doing the same show. I was still doing the same things, but because my intention changed, my purpose in what I was doing, this four had changed. My intention became about, how do I serve other people? How do I lift other people? When I realized that, everything in my life began to fall into place. So I want to talk to you about intention today. What is your intention in your career? Why did you choose it? What is your purpose? Because let me tell you, whatever you set your intention as, that is where you will land.